Starting off this Friday's video with Get Up Off of That Thang, a soulful brown ale from Devil May Care Brewing in Winnipeg. They do several music-themed beers. This is one of my favorites of them, and they've got a bit of a story about it here. You can pause if you'd like. But this is just a nice brown ale. Very, very nice indeed. And it pours nicely, too. So today, I'm taking a look at something from Dollarama's Halloween set of themed stuff this year. They don't do a lot of electronic stuff in their various seasonal things. Most of it is just, you know, the standard set string of battery-operated LEDs with a random plastic thing stuck to it to make it seasonal. This is a little strobe light with Halloween style packaging. Ooh. You can see through the window that it's got five LEDs in it, and it takes four AA cells. Nothing other than safety stuff on the back, so we don't need to worry about that. And the package is not that dangerous bonded together stuff. It's just stapled together, so that's nice. Again, up front we have a reflector with five LEDs on it. A little cover screwed on. What appears to be vents in the top, although I'm not expecting this to get all that hot. On the back we have an on-off switch and a speed control. A little cheap plastic mounting bracket. Battery compartment on the bottom. It could have a screw, but it doesn't. And it takes four AA cells, as mentioned earlier. So, what do we expect it to do? That's not strobing. Oh, there we go. I'll slow the speed down. I guess that was maximum speed. Yeah. So it's right now it's at maximum speed and it looks solid on. I'm assuming there's some flicker, although I can't even see that on the camera. Let's just slow it down a little bit. Yeah, that's kind of the fastest flicker that I can see. If we slow it right down, that's three quarters of a second, half a second, something like that. That's not bad. And oddly, as you can see, let's turn it back to solid. We have three different colors of LEDs. Oh, actually, is that three or five different colors of LEDs? I'm colorblind. I can't tell. To me, it looks like blue, kind of whitish, and then green and maybe something different on that side. So looking at it up close and through the camera, it's definitely five different colors of LEDs. Although colorblind me still can't tell you what those two are. That one might even be the pseudo infrared, possibly. Well, that is definitely different than I've seen in these things before. Big Clive looked at one of these, or similar one, about 5 years ago. But this one I think is that's obviously different, but that's easily changed, and we could change them to something different if we wanted to. But this may, in fact, be different than the one that he had, because the one that he had didn't have screws holding it together on the sides. So I am interested to see what the actual circuit inside this guy is. And that's the real reason that I bought it, of course. Let's just pull these screws out. They are, as usual, just little self-tapping screws into the plastic. So what I'm expecting to find in here is, oh, obviously just a basic little flashing circuit, either a couple of transistors or a 555. I doubt it's anything more specialized or fancy than that. So here we've got a little single-sided circuit board with what looks like mostly surface mount components on the other side. And over here we have the LED board with just the five LEDs in parallel. Different color LEDs in parallel and having them actually working, that is a bit of a surprise. Normally, different colors of LEDs are different voltages, different forward voltages to light them up, especially the reds and greens. The blues and whites are typically the same chemistry, just the different phosphors, but the reds and greens usually are a different chemistry inside, so I'm guessing that these are all just phosphor style. So it'll be like a bluish white in behind and then exciting a phosphor in whatever color you want. That's different. So let's yoink this little board out of here and see what's on the other side of it. I really hope it's not a blob chip. That would be really anticlimactic. Oh, it's a real chip. That's cool. And to go with it, one single component, which looks like it is a series resistor going to one of the LED lines. Okay. Let's see if we can get closer and figure out what that little dude is. They've gobbed some epoxy over that to obscure it. Let me see if I can do anything to try and make that a little bit more visible. Well, no matter how much I abuse this thing, chemicals, mechanical, whatnot, I cannot see a part number on it. But I did spend a little bit of time reverse engineering because it's such a simple circuit. And here we are. Positive voltage from the batteries, a switch. That voltage goes across the potentiometer, just so it's just voltage dividing and sending its voltage out to pin 6 of the 8-pin chip. Pin 8 is the negative voltage, pin 1 is positive voltage on the chip. No connection on pins 3, 5, and 4, which leaves pins 2 and 3, which are tied together. They go to the LEDs, and then the other side of the LEDs goes through the 33 ohm resistor back to minus voltage. So this thing switches high, and it's using 2 pins, just I guess for extra current, probably. And that's it. That's all there is to it. So this is like 99% likely to be a microcontroller. And just looking at where the power pins are on pin 1 and 8, of the common 8-pin microcontrollers, this is most likely to be a PIC or a PIC clone or something in that family. It's not an ATtiny, it's not an STM chip, it's not any other 8-pin microcontroller that I could find, but like I said, the only one with the power pins there and there is PIC, so that's likely what it is, or yeah, like a cheap knockoff. Now just for fun, let's clamp a power supply onto this thing and see how much current it draws when it's running. Which way is on? Probably that way. Power on. Is it really drawing 900 milliamps? Or do I have that switched the wrong way? I do. I've got the power on it backwards. Well, let's see if that microcontroller has reverse polarity protection built into it. Or did I just bloat it up? Oh no, it still works. Cool. And let's turn that up to full speed, which is basically indistinguishable from constant. And it's drawing about 48, so let's say 50 milliamps. So bugger all. Well, let's say 50 milliamps, divide that by the 5 LEDs, so 10 milliamps each, which means those batteries in it will last forever, especially when you've got it down to a lower duty cycle and a lower speed. What else can we tell about this thing? I guess we could change the LEDs as long as they're all matched voltages. I guess we could also find out what the forward voltage of those LEDs is. That might be interesting to note. I'm going to guess that they're going to be right around 3-ish volts. Let's turn that right up to full again. And get in here, what do we got? 3.0 volts exactly. So those are going to be essentially a white LED internally with just different colors phosphors on it. That's kind of neat. I hadn't encountered that in the, I'm assuming these are reds and greens on this end. Again, I'm sure somebody will correct me, but that is the technology that's always been used for the blues and the whites and stuff. So I suppose we could hack this thing a little bit. We could change the LEDs, like I said. What else? We could, I suppose, add a transistor to it to drive the LEDs a lot harder. I wouldn't want to, well, you could replace that current limiting diode or resistor in there to make them less bright, but they're already not super bright. And in a completely dark space, they would work okay, I guess. But it's not going to compete with xenon unless you put much bigger LEDs in there, like I said, and then you'd need to add a driver circuit, because I'm guessing the fact that the 60 milliamps is enough for this, or more than enough for one pin on this microcontroller, that it probably increasing the current would likely kill it. So other than that, I don't know that there's much else you could mess around with this thing. I suppose you could just rip the board out and put LEDs in, just not flashing LEDs. Or I suppose you could also put in some of the self-flashing LEDs, although that would get a bit chaotic, but it might be kind of neat. I don't know. Some ideas, I suppose. Anyway, yeah, just a quick, simple little video. I saw this thing. I thought it might be interesting to take a look at it. So here we are. Yeah, questions, comments, if there are any, down below. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.